Okay, welcome to another edition of Tips and Traps with David Adam. We're taking a look at Jake Walkinshaw here from Seymour, Connecticut. Tall right-handed pitcher, against Franklin Pierce. He's pitching for the Seacoast Mavericks on this night. And right there, we're checking his ball break timing. Just a slight jackknife right there as he's still got the ball in his glove. He's trying to get that lower half going towards the target. Strength of Jake right here is his foot strike timing. As you can see, he does a nice job lining up his front side. Comes off his back heel pretty well, which he gets a little bit of hip rotation, creating a decent amount of hip-shoulder separation. We run into little problems here as we watch Jake rotate into his release point. You can see that right shoulder kind of pops up on him. That kind of pushes his head off his target line a little bit, and he loses just a little bit momentum on that final crucial turn at release point and through release point. So this is a point we're going to try to expand out for Jake and help him out a little bit. Jake's velocity has been sitting between, really fluctuating between 85 and 89 miles per hour this year. We believe a main reason for that, again, is his head movement and shoulder angularity rotation. Again, the strength of Jake's delivery is his front side being nice and closed, that foot strike, and he tries to really come off nicely off that back toe. Again, creating decent hip-shoulder separation. As he comes into release point, again, keep an eye on his shoulder rotation and his head movement to and through his release point. We believe with a little help here, we can improve his velocity slightly here. As you can see, just comes off the ball a little bit into his release point there on this particular throw. We'll let him finish it off here as he gets down through it. And he tries to stay down through it here. And again, we're going to look at that right shoulder as it pinches in and kind of pops his head off to that glove side at release point, just after release point. Again, we believe a nice big tip here for Jake would be to help control that angularity of his shoulder rotation a little bit. You can see he tries to stay down through that one a little bit better there. As we break it down, as we can see, a little better angularity there as he little leveler and tries to come down through that shoulder rotation. We believe this pitch probably was 88 to 89 miles per hour. I believe possibly with the slight adjustment here, we could see Jake's velocity increase into the low 90s.